Turn your ear, O Lord, and answer me. Save the servant who trusts in you, my God. Have mercy on me, O Lord, and I cry to you all day long. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy.
Lord of mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy.
Christ of mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who cause the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers, your faith has been a great comfort to us in the middle of our own troubles and sorrows. Now we can breathe again, as you are still holding firm in the Lord. How can we thank God enough for you, for all the joy we feel before our God on your account? We are earnestly praying night and day to be able to see you face to face again, and make up any shortcomings. May God, our Father himself, and our Lord Jesus Christ, make it easy for us to come to you. May the Lord be generous in increasing your love, and make you love one another and the whole human race as much as we love you. And may he so confirm your hearts in holiness, that you may be blameless in the sight of our God and Father, when our Lord Jesus Christ comes with all his saints. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response. Fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
Fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
You turn men back into dust and say, go back, sons of men. To your eyes a thousand years are like yesterday, come and gone, no more than a watch in the night.
Fill us with your love that we may rejoice.
Make us know the shortness of our life, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Lord, relent is your anger forever. Show pity to your servants.
Fill us with your love and may we rejoice.
In the morning, fill us with your love. We shall exult and rejoice all our days. Let the favor of the Lord be upon us. Give success to the work of our hands.
Fill us with your love that may we rejoice.
Alleluia, alleluia. I call you friends, says the Lord, because I have made known to you everything I've learned from my Father. Alleluia. The Lord be
with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, stay awake, because you do not know the day when your master is coming. You may be quite sure of this, that if the householder had known at what time of the night the burglar would come, he would have stayed awake and would not have allowed anyone to break the wall of his house. Therefore you too must stand ready, because the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. What sort of servant then is faithful and wise enough for the master to place him over his household to give them their food at the proper time? Happy that servant of his master's arrival and finds him at this employment. I tell you solemnly, he will place him over everything he owns. But as for the dishonest servant who says to himself, my master is taking his time and sets about beating his fellow servants and eating and drinking with drunkards, His master will come in a day he does not expect, and at an hour he does not know. The master will cut him off and send him to the same fate as the hypocrites, where there will be weeping and grinding of teeth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are called to be watchful in prayer at all times, with trust and confidence let us pray to God for all our needs. Let us pray that we may take to heart the warning to be always watchful for the coming of the day of the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for the grace to be faithful servants of the Lord, attentive to our daily duties and working to the best of our abilities. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
And we pray for all who have died. And remember the anniversaries of Pascal Devine, Harry Craney, Catherine Breen, Peter and Mary McGarrity and deceased members of the McGarrity family, and Kathleen Murphy.
May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. Let us pray. Father, we are the people you have chosen as your own, and we give thanks. Be our protection and our help at all times, through the saving merits of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And may the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gift of unity and peace in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be
with your spirit.
Lift up your
heart. Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining you, O holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we exclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory,
your
Son
and the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the Lord. O Son of the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fire. By sending down your Spirit upon them like the true fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring to the fullness of charity, together Francis, our Pope, and Eamon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, and who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and all by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you
all. And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say
the words of my soul. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from
you. Amen.
Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us so that in all things we may please you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son.